I choose to study Salmonella for my research because I'm a microbiologist by profession, and Salmonella is one of the leading causes of sepsis, and globally, it's a problem in gastroenteritis, food poisoning, but because it's a leading cause of invasive disease in sub-Saharan Africa, and particular lineages have been described, we felt that it was important that we also characterize the Salmonella that we have in the Gambia to look out for these particular strains that are described in sub-Saharan Africa. The implication for treatment is that it is important that we know what the most resistant antimicrobials are, so that those are not given to patients when they present to the clinic. I am very excited about this project because it's the first project that is looking at Salmonella at the whole genome sequencing level. We just published an article that although we find low rates of multi-drug resistance, antibiotic resistance, we have found that we have multi-drug resistance. So we have gram-negative organisms that are resistant to more than one class of antimicrobials. Although the rates are low, but it's interesting to know that we have resistance to different classes of antibiotics. Yes, the research has really improved me as a scientist, as a researcher. It's improved my critical thinking, skills, my cognitive thinking, and it's made me realize that it's not just enough just sitting on the bench and saying, yeah, this patient is infected with Salmonella, but it's important to know what is going around in your surrounding. So you know if a patient has Salmonella, what is the likely type of Salmonella that this patient has? Well, coming from the part of the world that we come from, we are very resource limited. So resources, we don't always find enough resources to really look at each patient in detail. So it's important that we have an understanding of what is going on in the surrounding to help clinicians give the right treatment to the patient at the right time. So data that comes out from my unit is actually used to inform decisions, mainly policies across the country, from vaccines to clinical care to public health decisions. So this research actually will be of great public health significance. I'm a mother of four, so that alone is a huge challenge. I work full-time as well as do my research. So the dynamics are quite different from probably someone that is just focused on their research and not on other things. So having to do full-time research work as a microbiologist, overseeing a full microbiology lab in my unit, and also involved in research, it takes a lot of dedication, it takes a lot of commitment, and yes, I sacrifice a lot of my time to be able to do this because it's something that I have passion for. So I see patients, on a daily basis. I see, I test their samples, but I feel going the extra mile to really look at what is going on in our surrounding is really, really important.